washes by in the wet. It is glistening flesh in the deep marine, in the deep marine. There is room for make-believe out in the ocean. There is room for make-believe out on the land, in the wet, in the dream. If it's flesh and seen in the deep marine, in the deep marine.
As long as I can remember, I always wanted to ride giant waves. I've been around surfing since I was a little kid, and wanting to ride big waves was a dream. All the guys that were my heroes were the guys that rode the giant waves. And that for me is the apex of surfing. Everything else is you know, a stage down.
Laird Hamilton is widely regarded as the top surfer in the world, and a pioneer of the most extreme form of the sport, surfing the biggest waves on Earth. No one can make her, no one
can break her down. Out in the ocean, I'm in control of my fate. I make the mistake, I pay the consequence. Ultimately, I think when you don't get to experience this kind of sensation, you're missing one of the few times in your life where you're actually kind of in control of your destiny.
Waves this size have terrifying power. One mistake can crush a surfer to death or pin him underwater until he drowns.
I really believe that we've yet to experience the ultimate day, and that I hope in the next 10 or 15 years that I'm able to ride a day that I'll probably never see again in my lifetime.
Hamilton's dream to ride ever bigger waves has brought him to the Hawaiian island of Maui. This remote outpost of the United States sits in the middle of the Pacific Ocean, over 2,000 miles off the US mainland. Tucked away behind endless fields of pineapple is the spot where, on the right day, one of the world's truly giant waves breaks. Local surfers have nicknamed this place Jaws.
A lot of people that have lived on this island for a long time don't even know where it is, because it's out off of a big cliff and you have to know when it's breaking. And if you go there on 300 days of the year, you can't see it. It's dead flat and there's no sign of it. And then when it wakes up, there's no missing it.
Well, we're here, Jaws, one of the premier big waves in the world, and it's breaking today. The first time I saw this break, I had butterflies in my stomach, and I thought, here it is, here's the spot. Right now you have nothing to measure it. There's no scale, but when you put a human on one of these waves today that you'll see break, the range is somewhere in the 30-foot base range. So 6 times bigger than a small human, or 5 times bigger than a larger human.
These 30-foot waves are far bigger than most surfers will ever dare to take on. But with a big Pacific swell, they have been known to reach over 70 feet, producing curling barrels so big you could drive a truck through them. Jaws is the Mount Everest of the surfing world. Hamilton's love of dangerous sports started early in his life. He was born in California, but moved to Hawaii in the mid-60s. There, his mother married Laird's stepfather, Bill Hamilton, one of the champion stylists of the surfing world. Bill saw his stepson drawn to the thrill of danger even as a young child.
When the surf was flat in the old days, the guys who rode big waves to get their thrills or their jollies would go to these falls, and they're about 80 feet from the top to the bottom, and that's where you jump off or dive. I took Laird up to the 40-foot level, which is kind of the beginning level. He says, where do the big guys jump off? I said, up there. He says, I want to go up there and look. So I took him all the way up, the 80-foot mark. You know, and I'm standing there looking down, and all of a sudden I see this little blonde hair rushing past me. And I go, and there he goes. He jumped right off, just like. And I looked, I go, you okay? Yeah, I want to do it again. He was 8 years old.
It's kind of that whole leap of faith, you know, where you practice being someplace and making a commitment. You get up there, you jump or you don't. You don't kind of jump or, you know, it's like, it's real defined decision making. It's important in surfing. You know, you can't kind of catch a wave. You need to either be on it or you either not be on it and make that decision.
Well, I think it means everything to Laird to do these extreme things. I think it's his whole personality. He wants to be on top of everybody on terms of extreme sports. It just means a lot to him.
Hamilton is not the only adrenaline junkie in search of giant waves. Here on Maui, he is part of a crew of like-minded surfers who together ride the most dangerous breakers on the planet. For this group, the surfing experience transcends everything else in their lives.
He made the mistake of when we
were. I think one of the reasons why you like to surf out there is you do get that feeling of just fear, total fear. And then you have to overcome it and go, no, it's not the fear that I'm attracted to, it's the conquering of fear.
Putting loud on it? Are you putting loud on it?
Everything in my life kind of revolves around it. I like all the so-called action sports. I mean, if it is death-defying, that's where I come in.
Riding big waves has given me a lot of spiritual growth. The power that is being released in that wave, to be that close to it and draw some of that energy in, gives you a real high on life. It's a very natural thing, and it's very pure.
There's nothing like having a great experience. The only thing better is sharing a great experience. And so when you have these guys that you're like-minded and doing the same things, having the time of your life, it's really magnified because you're sharing in the experience and you have a bond that few other ways in your life will ever give you.
Together, the group have taken on big waves all over the world, gaining a reputation for unrivaled skill and courage. This season, Hamilton and his buddies are planning to initiate a new recruit into the highs of big wave surfing. John Denney moved to Maui 5 years ago. Like Hamilton, John hopes to ride Jaws, but he's not looking for a giant swell. Since it will be his first time on a big wave, he's just hoping he can get a ride and live to tell the tale.
Good surf, good surf.
I netted.
I've always loved surfing. I've always loved the idea of surfing. And then when I moved here, sort of like a surfer's dream come true. Suddenly I'm hanging out with Laird Hamilton, Dave Kalama. I hang out with people I've been reading about for years and years and years.
John has been hooked since Laird took him out on the water to see Jaws up close.
First time I went out was on a little Zodiac boat with Laird. He took me up there and I was just scared out of my wits. I'm just like, are you kidding me? And he dropped anchor and I'm like, you think you were a little close?
Since that time, John has assisted the crew riding the backup boat, carrying extra boards, medical supplies, and photographers.
I've been so close, you know, but I've never really touched it. And so there's just something about it. It just might be fun to give it a try. You know, I'm backside out there and I really don't have anything to prove. But it just looks like it'd be a lot of fun, and Laird thinks it'd be fun, so why not?